I'm just excited. I have been following some of your webinars for the past few months, and I see that you have really done a great job in contributing to, you know, the tools and methods that we can use during this pandemic era.
Thank you so much. That's right. I mean, we really realized, I think, early on the value of these virtual site visits, because, I mean, what happened was this technology has been around for us to use for 6 years already. For all the meeting planners, it's free. And all the DMCs and event agencies, it doesn't cost anything. There's an organization, actually there's lots of organizations in different countries who create all types of virtual site visits. But there's a big difference in this one, the platform that we're using today, because it's MICE compliant. So it really has been built for meeting planners and event organizers and those that are remotely choosing locations for their guests or themselves, even for staycationing. So we're gonna enter visualize a visit, and today our destination will be Croatia. And first of all, we'll see a lovely, like a Zagreb aerial view. And I'm gonna do full screen, so you're gonna be able to enjoy this view. So Ed, have you been to Zagreb?
Yes, I have actually been there. I had some leisure and incentive groups. We have always included Zagreb in the Croatian leg of our trip. And it's good to know that they have also been actually identified as one of the cities to go to after the pandemic. So this is really a nice presentation and very interesting one.
Definitely, I have noticed the lists that are now being published in a lot of different sources. And that's actually what I'm tuning in as well, is I just looked at the list of 10 locations for April, where we could be traveling. We're both located in Finland at the moment. So for us, we're not the, you know, in the worst list of the pandemic. You know, we're definitely still maintaining the control, although the cases are going up, but we have more restrictions this month. However, there are still flights to several locations. Croatia at the moment is in the red area, so we're not able to fly directly. I mean, their entry requirements, I think they will open them in a short while. There was just a little spike over this summer and then winter, so it's been obviously one of those areas that we hoped that would have stayed as good as it was. It was actually also the last location I was in before the lockdown. So March 6th to 2020, we were attending the Conventa in, and then we went to Croatia to do some rock climbing and flew out on the last flight before they basically said no more. I was in Germany for 4 months, you know, just completely on a lockdown then. But here we are now looking at the beautiful city. And here you see the historical center as well. I mean, this is one of the favorite cities, I think, for most people who have been there, and definitely in the bucket list. And we can look at the map as well. Let's see how we get here. So when I go off full screen, we have the satellite map. So basically, those that are not maybe familiar with exactly where it is, you can see how close to wine areas we are. I mean, Croatia is known for good wine as well. Are you a fan of wine, Ed?
Yes, I do. Of course, I'm not an expert. I cannot say that. But yeah, I have actually tasted some wines there when I was there in Zagreb. And I think they produce decent wines. And they're actually emerging as a competitor, for example, with Italy and these kind of countries.
Definitely. And I mean, it's a cost-effective location as well. And during these webinars that we have organized for the past 12 months, the destination tours, we're really promoting locations that we also think that are COVID regulated. So they're really good at making sure that, you know, the safety is appropriate also for business meetings, but the leisure side as well. I'm doing a little aerial 360 here for you. So I'm basically moving my own mouse so you can see around the 360. And not every city allows the aerial, the drone photography. In Finland, we're in a lucky country that we can do that. Netherlands, for example, Amsterdam doesn't allow these kind of images at all. So we are fortunate to have it from a beautiful city like here. Today we have a, sorry, yes, carry on.
Yes, I noticed that you were able to get a drone shot. Yeah, it's good that you have mentioned it because many cities nowadays have banned the use of a drone, especially in tourist areas, probably because of some particular reasons. But here you can see that you have had a very, very nice aerial panoramic view of the city, and it's so lovely.
That's right, and it just really, you know, gets you kind of like in the atmosphere of traveling and wanting to go back there. I'm sure that now, you know, this has become at least, you know, one of the top destinations, like you said, after COVID. And we have this sign here, which is step into our hotel. So we're going to now just click that and we are imported into the lobby. So this is the lobby area of a hotel called Dubrovnik, although it's located in Zagreb. So it says it's open 24/7. And we can look at the lobby features as well. As it says, it's in the middle of the square, the main square in Zagreb. So we have these arrows which help you to navigate throughout the destination. What we know that has changed, as we know, we do update our presentations, you know, frequently, but here they do wear masks and they also have plexiglasses front of the reception area. So when you're arriving, there's also, you know, the hygienic protocols already in place. And then you have either stairs or then you can use the arrows. Let's just look a little bit around so we see the entry as well. So there's the square. And then we go back. And here is our first reception area for the meetings. And again, you can see that each hotel does their own setups. And here the Christmas setup is still on. We updated this during winter. So you can see that the theme correlates with that.
Yes, it looks nice from this angle.
Yeah, I mean, this is like a really nice way of, again, you know, choosing your Christmas events. And, you know, we can do hybrid events here as well for 2021. And you can see that this floor plan has these interactive tags. So we can also look at, first of all, how the crowd flows around this space. The biggest area is the Centrum Hall, and we can click that. And we are straight in. This is a cocktail reception setup here. So this is one of the properties. We, of course, have several to choose from. And since we're going to look at Split as well, during this same webinar, we're just going to go briefly through this one. But I actually would like to share the link so you can actually choose this yourself. So I have two options. What I just did was I copy-pasted the URL, or I can go and copy-paste this one. So we can share the link directly from the presentation. And I put it in the chat. So all of you attending the webinar are able to then enjoy this specific presentation. So what it does is it actually enters you directly to this location, I mean the room itself, but you can navigate back to the outside and back to the conference lobby and so forth yourself as well from that presentation. So that's how easy it is to share. You can put it in your WhatsApp to your clients or your team as you're planning your meeting.
Yes, I'm not good.
That
we can have at least the links, for example, because of course, after the presentation, we want to go back and look maybe further or maybe, you know, even ask for some particular questions and also with reference to the pictures that we have just, you have just presented.
Definitely, and here, like you said, if we have specific questions, it's so easy to just refer, like by copy pasting this here. As you can see, I'm using Mac, so it's just drop and, you know, copy paste, basically drag and drop. And then if you look at the link on the left, it changes as I'm zooming in. So it will be specifically, if you want to ask about the podium, you can zoom in and then send that link and ask about it. So it gives us a tool to work with events and plan them. I also like to use it for event website. So if we want to highlight the rooms where everybody's staying, let's go to standard king room. We can send this one, the 360. So all the guests, the attendees can also see what type of room they have. And that way they can, you know, make a choice, educated choice, whether they want to book this room or some other room, maybe an upgrade.
Yeah, it's always good that you can go and play around with the picture. I mean, it's not a still photo. Sometimes, you know, people nowadays, they know that it's easy to really present a nice photo, and then you are having problem with the expectation versus reality. But with this tool, you can actually see the actual, you know, all corners of the bedroom.
That's right. And when you talk about the, you know, managing expectations, I'm actually suspecting, I mean, what also the statistics and questionnaires are stating in the industry is that people are investing more in their trips now when they're, you know, the regulations lift up. So we actually have a better budget to use, and therefore we'll be a bit more, you know, particular and picky what rooms we want. And I'm sure more people will also upgrade because, you know, after a year or two, having not been abroad or traveling, I mean, a lot of people will go all in.
That's correct. That's correct. Even our clients in Asia, they are just really excited to travel, and they're waiting for the Schengen border to open. And I think a lot of people have had some savings that is really intended for traveling once the restrictions are lifted.
Exactly. I mean, that is such a correct thing, you know, like we are, I think each of us, whether we are in industry or outside of the industry, our bucket list is, you know, rapidly growing. It's like, oh, I didn't do this, you know, when I was able to. So the moment that, you know, we're able to travel, we probably start ticking from the top end of that bucket list instead of somewhere in the middle.
That's correct.
I'm going to show you a video. So we jumped, you know, just within seconds to a new location. So now we're actually already in Split. So I'm going to just highlight the location so you know where we are. In terms of destination itself, you know, it's a beautiful coastal area with islands. A very famous island, Hvar, is located right outside of it. This is a, I would say, archaeologically also a fantastic, really intriguing destination. And here we have Le Méridien, a beautiful property. I mean, this is a relaxing location, but it also suits really well for meetings and staycationing, longer stays. So we have a video, and I'm going to just share the computer sound so you will be able to hear this ambience that we're going to present. So you can just sit back and enjoy. So health was a key word there. And that's another trend now in travel and also in business, is that companies are recognizing the difficult situation that we are in and how it's affecting also all the employees. So incentive trips and also rewarding, as in presidential clubs or these type of programs, I think there's even bigger need for that one. Have you noticed that there's been a rise on corporates maybe looking at incentivizing in some other ways than travel, because I mean, how can you do it now except with material gifts? Because no one is able to go to these beautiful places until end of the year.
That is true. Actually, I just talked with some of my corporate clients. They have already started doing some strategies on how to, you know, enforce or develop the well-being of their employees, especially post-COVID, since most of them are really not, you know, we are not used to this being staying at home all the time. And even remote working at home is taking a toll on a lot of employees who are very sociable.
Yes, that's the thing. I mean, no one is, how you say, so strong that it wouldn't affect. So, as you know, social butterflies, extroverts and introverts, doesn't really matter, because like we are in an unusual situation and there's more limitations coming towards us, you know, it doesn't necessarily look like, you know, it's lifting in some places. So just the extension, you know, that it continues and continues, that's also, you know, because we don't really know exactly when we are free again. And now we understand also what freedom means in a completely different way.
Absolutely agree with you on that.
Yeah, I mean, that's why I think, again, I mean, I personally have taken a lot of trips to nature. So we do remote working from huts or cottages in Scandinavia. But at the same time, now I just read from a newspaper saying that only the brave and vaccinated can travel. I mean, you know, they like to do these massive slogans. But I am amongst the brave, so I haven't been vaccinated yet. So we did book a trip, you know, so we're going for 3 weeks to a remote working location. Again, you know, avoiding crowds, avoiding people, cooking from, you know, from the Airbnb that we booked. So, I mean, there are options, you know, that if you do it in a very safe kind of, you know, practical manner of looking after, you know, the hygiene, I'm sure that we can enter back to the traveling and meetings as well.
That is true. A lot of people are actually, you know, there are always a group of people who are risk takers. And of course, I'm not saying that we should be, you know, not minding this pandemic, but I think there are always certain ways to make yourself safe. And there are always a lot of places where, for example, in your case, remote working is very much ideal.
Yeah, that's the thing. And just being mindful of others. And we hired a camper van just last summer. So we were working from Norwegian, you know, fjords. And I mean, literally did not meet people. I mean, you would pay behind this flexi screen, you know, with your credit card for the petrol that you're purchasing. But I mean, that's a really minimal contact. So, I mean, there are ways to still, you know, contribute. And then grocery store is another one. In Germany, they implemented this really, really good protocol of, you know, having those stickers on the floors where you have to stand. In Finland, we don't yet have that, but it teaches you the meaningfulness of keeping distance as well. And I mean, I'm happy to go to meetings that they call social distancing business events, where, you know, you have the one direction flow. And that's what we're looking at here as well. So we have a meeting space here. And when we're looking at the floor plan, we're really identifying the one-way crowd control, you know, where we need to have, obviously, you know, the hygienic hand sanitizer points and where the people will be moving into the actual meeting space and how they exit. So you're using different doors. So, I mean, when we are applying these COVID-safe regulations, we get to, you know, quite a good standard of safety, I would say. Of course, you know, if people don't respect the you know, the standards, then it's different. So this is a COVID-safe or social distancing setup. And we also ask about air conditioning. So a lot of hotels and venues have had to change their air conditioning and the filters to comply with the COVID regulations. And when we're doing venue finding now, during pandemic and after, we have a whole different set of questions that we never had before COVID.
That's true. Now everybody is asking if the number one question that most of the clients are, you know, like they will be sending emails and said, does the hotel have COVID protocols? How do they check in the guests? Can we pay? Are they serving buffet in breakfast? You know, these kind of things.
Exactly. And that's how we also, you know, discuss. We have the dialogues with all these properties that we have visualizer for. And we have requested the COVID details. So here you can see the PDF. I mean, it's on the right-hand corner. And when you got that link, you also have an access to this detail. So it just highlights, I can just zoom in a bit. So it just highlights, you know, what the protocols are. Each brand has their own. And for example, Hilton has the 10 touch point regulations. So for the meeting, so you see the doorknobs, you know, like, you know, the tables. I mean, it kind of highlights where people mostly are more tactile. And therefore, the cleanliness of those spaces or areas are kept higher than the, you know, the wall, for example, here. So, I mean, it sounds like common sense. But like you said, clients and us, we want to know that the hotel is aware and, you know, executing on these protocols.
That's true. That's true.
And I'm being quite analytical about this one, but I mean, we always used to look at the locations in terms of accessibility, you know, how the ambience, of course, the capacity counts a lot. You know, we have the capacity charts here as well. So you can really look at what the kind of fit is. These are actually regular capacities, so the maximum. And we just take a third or half, depending on where we are with the pandemic. 1.5 meters would mean that we go really somewhere around third, but some have 2 meters. So then we apply the half of that maximum capacity to the meeting space. And this is still actually in Croatia, a COVID safe setup. So again, different countries have different regulations.
Yeah, I presume that most of the hotels are, of course, presenting the new data on the carrying capacity of their function rooms, their congresses, because nowadays you cannot really, you know, if you base it on the pre-COVID maximum capacity of the function rooms, then it's not gonna be the same.
That's right. And I mean, within the industry, we know to you know, to half it or put a third of that maximum. So we know how to calculate it. But then not everybody, you know, for example, a client doesn't necessarily, if it's a corporate or association, doesn't necessarily know how to do that. So, and also, like we said, you know, each country has their own specific regulations as well. We know with Latvia, for example, they can have 2 people seated. What we see now is classroom style. But in Latvia, you have actually COVID regulation with 2 in each table. So, you know, there's quite a lot of variations. World Health Organization, of course, applies the 1.5 meters. So then that means 1 person, even if there's space for the second on that same table. But I mean, that's what we do really. And I mean, we have lots of these really beautiful setups and beautiful rooms to show. But again, I think we're all also interested in the dining. So let's go to the restaurant areas. And here we have the 7 Palms, and it's with the views of Adriatic Sea. I mean, having been in the Northern Europe the whole time, you know, now since summer, these places start to look extremely exotic as well. I mean, I used to take it for granted that, you know, we could just go anywhere and we would fly to these places every week. And now it's, I think it has increased our appreciation as well. I just see that I think I must dropped our second panelist. So let's see, that was probably the Wi-Fi connection. I don't know, for some reason, we also have noticed, I mean, a lot of places we are using a lot more Wi-Fi, the bandwidth, and that means that, you know, even the Zoom and Teams, all these meetings are slowing down a little bit. But let's look at the restaurant features here again for this exclusive restaurant. So it says barbecue and grill. And one thing that has happened during this the lockdown and, you know, during the pandemic is that I think I've become like a mini master chef. So no, the food is not as good. Might look, you know, okay, but it's the fact that just cooking so much more and really investing on quality products as well, quality ingredients. We have a really nice Kuster Beach Club here, and this is actually one of the highlights of this property. So I'm going to show a video so you can see the ambience on that one as well. It's quite a treat to have such a good variety in the same property. So now we are in the ambience of the Kuster Beach Club, and there's a lizard as a, you know, like a little logo, but that one really is a wordplay because Kuster also means the relaxation or the, you know, funkiness of the restaurant. So they have really, you know, succeeded. I was here in this property about a year and a half ago and absolutely loved the lunch. And we did have cocktails in this area, and I would highly recommend for any holiday, whether it's your boardroom meeting, leadership retreat, for any kind of purpose, actually, the Le Méridien in Split, it is a really highly, highly recommended location, really good standard of service, and rooms are fantastic. It's very modern. When we look at the public areas, let's go to the lobby area. You see that the architecture, you know, it is contemporary, but it's very white and light, and it really is what you see here. So it doesn't let you down, that's for sure. And then because of the Croatian hospitality, you know, the fantastic food and people, you really feel welcome here. So I would put that in one of the bucket lists, you know, that you might have to visit, you know, in the upcoming months or years when we are able to again feel free, like we have been. I mean, we definitely go back to that. And then the gym area itself, it's very airy. And because there's limited number of people who can train there at the same time now, you will have enough space to also keep fit. And I mean, what's even better, you can go and run on the promenade. There's a really nice modern promenade going behind and around this property. So it's definitely a highlight. And then you have a lovely indoor spa. In Finland, we were able to visit spas still now. So been fortunate to go a couple times, of course, being a bit wary about the situation. But we only had so few cases at the time that you know, it seemed like a good idea. But I wouldn't, if I were in Germany or somewhere else, I wouldn't actually go to gyms or spas either because of the, you know, higher number of cases and more people. And now we see the rooms, like I said, very contemporary, lovely views to the either to the mountains or then to the sea. So you will have spectacular classic room like this one is with the park view. And then we have the classic sea view. And you can see the islands and the coastline there. So it is super lovely. And this one is with the spacious and relaxing ambience and panoramic windows leading up to the balcony. So basically you can have your breakfast in room. Let's see, now we have, luckily, let me see if I can make a co-host. Just a second. So Eddie's back. Lovely.
It's problem with network.
Yes, I think you're able to now. Yeah, that's really happens to us all the time. I was actually just saying that, you know, I've noticed that also Teams and go-to meetings and whichever tool you're using, but it is slowing down because there's so many more people using Wi-Fi at the moment.
Yeah, so. It does happen to me quite often, but you know, this kind of SOS in the network and signals, they quite happen in sets. Not a good
definitely.
Time.
Definitely, I mean, there's never a good time almost. It's like, I've noticed, I have boosters with me as well. Like I'm actually sometimes swapping between the service providers and yeah, but still it can happen. I was just raving about this beautiful contemporary feel and the design of this property. The you know, Le Méridien Split is really high on the bucket list. It is a one that I would recommend for any type of clientee. I was here having lunch and stayed with the team, the sales director, you know, showing the place, and also we were able to sample the food and wine, and I mean, it is one of my favorite properties in Croatia as a whole, just because you can't be disappointed with, first of all, it's on a yacht harbor, it's by the sea, and you have the mountain views, and it's contemporary and clean, and yeah, it's a super high level of property in that sense. They do have some rooms that haven't been, you know, recently renovated, like this one is their, you know, newest style. You can see the yacht harbor right there in front of it. And there's a promenade, by the way, which is, you know, you can walk for kilometers or run.
It seems like they really have a good location. And I was in Split once and I was able to buy actually a krabat there. Yes, for those who do not know, the necktie that we know nowadays, it actually originates from Croatia. And it's very interesting that they have such, you know, deep contribution to humanity. You know, the ties that we wear in the offices, it's actually originated from Croatia.
I think a lot of men would debate on that, whether it's a good thing. But I mean, I as a female, I love, you know, men with a cravat. That's really like, I think it's so beautiful look. But I mean, you know, a lot of times, you know, towards the end of the day in seminars, you know, people start to be like, oh, okay, you know. but yeah, definitely a good piece of outfit that I also would like to thank Croatia for inventing it. And then yeah. Here, look, you can see the fantastic Adriatic Sea.
Yeah, it's really in the harbor located. Is there a yacht club in front of it?
Yeah, so what's actually below this? So you see just on the, like I can zoom, but that's a promenade. So what you see here on the side, it's actually going around this hotel. There's several other hotels next to it and leading all the way to the city, Split. So you can walk this promenade all the way to the main Split. But there's a yacht club and there's the office right below of this building. This building is quite a large building. But so the locals also have their boats here. And any visiting is a guest harbor as well. So you can bring your guests or take them out on the sea from here. and you can rent one of the yachts there, but mainly it's a private yacht club. So it's just a great, you know, kind of clientele that also visits the hotel for lunch. You know, it does have some local you know, visitors in that sense from the yacht club.
Yeah, it's always a good, interesting plus factor for a hotel near the harbor, because I happened to organize one time with a group of incentive clients, and we moved from one property to the other via yacht. Mm. So here you can easily imagine how it feels like. You come to check in at this hotel, but you don't go by bus. Instead, you go by yacht.
Oh, that's one of the best things about Split, that you can do exactly that. And then there's the famous gallery. It's a you know, combining the historical and modern art gallery, and you can actually take a yacht there as well. So you can, you know, have the group staying in this hotel, enjoying all the, like, the Far Island as well with the yacht. And then even, you know, in the city, you can go by yacht because there's the harbor there as well. So everything works really well that way, for sure. And as said, when we were here with the business group, I mean, I don't have anything bad to say. I have to say that I couldn't find any faults, really. Just because it's one of the most modern parts as well of the whole Split. So if you're looking at business standards, you're getting a very high level. Of course, there's the historical, the castle, well, it's not really castle, basically the walls, the historical walls that are famous in Split that everybody wants to see. So you have such a beautiful contrast with this property.
Yes, and I can see that they have really good patios and outdoor restaurant, which is the trend nowadays. Some of the hotels are actually starting to rent adjacent properties where they can put the restaurants al fresco, because as the World Health Organization puts it, if you are outdoors, the risk of having the COVID is more minimized than having to stay with a lot of people indoors.
That's correct. There's crafts, a lot of these formulas that you can look at that within 15 minutes, the indoor air, if it doesn't have that higher filter or the air conditioning, within 15 minutes, it's already contaminated. So completely agree that with the weather as well, the climate, you know, being really pleasant in Croatia, you know, you can quite safely schedule your meetings and events and lunch and dinners in the outdoors. You know, it really does have quite a stable weather. And then this club here, it's really used with business as well. So Kuster is like a relaxing beach club. It has a wordplay, but I mean, when we were doing our meetings here, they were also really embracing and highlighting how this space is something that businesses like to use and privatize. So if there's any other guests in the building, this is a little bit on the side, so you can have this for your private group without privatizing the whole hotel. And you have your own wine cellar. They are really big on wines in this property, so you will find some exquisite wines here as well.
Oh, that's very nice that you can already present this to clients, you know, even before the client have stepped inside the hotel. You can see that having this information beforehand will really make decision-making more faster and can really influence heavily, especially when you have people who are, for example, interested in wining and dining.
And when they're traveling from further away, like even from now, from us, from Finland or Asia or wherever, these experiences stay in heart as well. You know, when you find something quite unique and there's a sommelier who will present it. And here you have also the chef's tasting matched with the wines, and it's a private room. So in the wine cellar, you can have something quite unique. You can also ask them to bring something if you have a wine in mind, that or winery from Croatia that you would like to present here. So you can organize any kind of event in this space. And then we have the underside pub, which is more of the rough and rugged, you know, fun place. And again, you know, if you have a gaming company, tech company, we will go back to these events as well. So no worries. You have the option here to to have a more playful atmosphere.
It's very hip and trendy. I think these are more for the young professionals, but of course it goes beyond all age boundaries, but it's nice to see that they have this kind of entertainment.
And the sports bar, just in case, you know, you have in your guests some that are following the Premier League or they follow, Bundesliga, you're able to watch those games here as well. So then maybe not the whole group or snooker, in matter of fact. I think they're showing, or is that tennis? No, that's tennis. So, but in any case, you can come here, during your stay as well. So give some extra interest to that one. And then finally, we have the yacht club terrace. So here you can see, so most of these yachts are, like said, they're private. So you see some locals and guests walking there on the promenade.
Yes. Lemerijan has other properties aside from Split, right? I mean,
yes.
When you talk about Croatia, they have also properties in other cities.
That's correct. We haven't yet onboarded all the Lemeridians from Croatia, but we can always request them. So if there's specific cities, I guess Zagreb being one, and then Dubrovnik, of course, we are working on that one so we get more of those presentations, because it will be nice to combine. And next week we're going to present Intercontinental from three locations from France. And that's actually a really nice thing, because they're all under the same link. So we have three different cities, three different intercontinentals. And that's what we would like to do with Le Méridien as well. So it's just a matter of either you asking from us that you need one and we then go and ask, or we just try to motivate, to get all three. Properties are noticing how virtual site visits are becoming norm. So they are now more open to also give us those. And we actually have a product which is free. So it doesn't include 360 images, but it includes what you see now. These are still images. So it still includes the, if we go here, the floor plans, etc. So you will still get these ones as a property. However, that will be a free version of Visualizer. So we can always add those as well. And it still gives the same ambience on the kind of, I would say, still image level. There's a difference. But then we're also introducing an augmented version. So I'm excited to announce this, that within weeks, we will be showing a completely gamified, as in, people like to debate on what's 3D, but this is super 3D, because you will be able to basically be within the space. We scanned a whole property in Amsterdam during COVID, just in January. It took 2 weeks. And something positive about, I guess, situation like lockdown is that the property that was empty was easier to scan. And we have a digital twin of that property now to showcase.
Wow, that sounds very exciting, because nowadays people want some more interactivity. Like as you have described it, it seems like if I'm right, you can actually walk through the property as if you are there yourself. And instead of having like a 3D experience, you can have can even be considered like hologram or something, like you are inside the hotel property itself.
That's exactly. And what's interesting is in that meeting space as well, we are able to put, for example, our face, your or my face on the screen as we're having a webinar or, our virtual event. So you can swap, where in the room we basically are showing instead of what we have here, our Zoom picture. It becomes exactly more interactive. So we have a partner company that we work with in collaboration, and we will be producing more of these augmented virtual site visits, but that's really something. So we have the whole spectrum of going from 360 that is mice compliant, so you don't get lost in the in the virtual tour. You all the time see where you are. And then this augmented reality one that enables you to do even a different type of event.
I really hope that it will be a standard for all hotels to have this kind of technology, because nowadays people are relying so much on the internet and the social media. They do their own research, and you know, with Visualizer spearheading this kind of progress in terms of presentation, I think it will be really interesting if all the hotels, major hotels at least, will be having this kind of technology.
Yeah, I think it will make our life easier. So, because now when we are more particular what kind of trips we make, I think we also spend more time researching, but actually we'll become more efficient. So instead of searching for sources and trying to combine, you know, PDFs and lists and all that material, we just have one location, one presentation, we click it and it has all everything that we need in our industry, you know, as travel bookers. It's different when you're, you know, doing something for leisure. You might not need the capacity charts or floor plans, but certainly in our industry, we do need that as well.
That's right. And it makes our job, I mean, talking from the side of the event and travel organizers, I think it will also make our job very easy in terms of presentation and in terms of convincing our clients that this is the hotel that would be very perfect for your group.
Definitely. We have now identified how now it feels like our job is also becoming, you know, appreciated because we get better tools. So we are using the materials that venues and hotels provide us or create. And that's really how we then attract them to that hotel. So we're the extension of the sales team. And I'm also really delighted to hear that, you know, there's an increasing interest to really present the properties in a more visual way like this one. So this is a Visualizer visit. And we are now approaching the end of our webinar. Thank you so much, Ed, for joining us today. And I hope you will come back again.
Thank you, Anna and Sheila. I'm having fun. This is my first, and hopefully this will be not my last. Yeah. And I learned a lot through this Visualizer presentation, and I can, of course, discuss this with some of my networks in the hotel industries, in the MICE and the other travel-related and tourism-related people. So it's good that we have this kind of tools for us to avail whenever we want to reach out more to our clients who are locked down in their homes at the moment.
Exactly, like easier to make decisions as well. Well, excellent. So yeah, let's see. We meet again in the, you know, upcoming weeks. And those that are just tuning in or watching this on a recording, we are presenting the Intercontinental Paris in the first week of April. Next week, we will still carry on with the presentations from, well, actually, we're going to have one from Hoi An. It's the Four Seasons. And then we are looking at some other really beautiful properties. So tune in Tuesday and Thursday, 11 o'clock Central European time. And thank you and have a really lovely day, everybody.
Bye. Ciao.
Ciao. Bye.